Andy, for years people have been using gold tin in high temperature applications, but we have the ongoing problem of voiding.
Sure. It's not just high temperature applications, but applications like LED, where the high thermal electrical conductivity are a prerequisite for the usefulness of the solder. What we've noticed is that in the last several years, because people are using gold plating on both the die side and on the substrate side, and certainly the substrate side in some instances, there's been an increase in voiding that's been seen, and it seems to correlate with the amount of gold that's present from those. So we took a look a while back at the ratio of gold that's present in terms of thickness on both the die and the substrate, and correlated that with the amount of voiding, and again showed that there was a significant correlation between the two. What seems to be happening is that the gold tin eutectic is actually being pushed away from its minimum point at 280 degrees C off to one side, and you can actually see this from the phase diagram. As you move to a high gold, you actually increase the liquidus quite significantly. So this means that as the joint cools down from its initial phase, the voids that are present there actually shrink down as they normally do during the cooling process. But as they hit the high temperature liquidus, they're actually frozen in place by the intermetallics and they can't shrink any further. So you actually get a minimum of voiding when you have a eutectic in the final solder joint. So the question then is, okay, well, what can I do to actually reduce the amount of voiding by making a eutectic in the final solder joint rather than putting a eutectic solder into a gold sputtered system? So we generated a diagram that allows our customers to use this ratio of thickness of gold that's present from both the substrate and the die, and correlate that with the thickness of the preform or the thickness of solder paste that would be placed in between the two as part of the die attach. And then simply from that you can calculate how off eutectic your material needs to be. So of course there's a cost saving as well. If you're moving from 80% to 79% gold, there's quite a significant cost saving, obviously, from the reduction of gold. So you move to higher tin so that in the final reflow joint, the solder from the gold that's melting into this off-eutectic material will then achieve its eutectic and you'll have a minimized void.
Andy, what is Indium Corporation's recommendations to help resolve this problem?
If customers are having these issues with gold sputtered or gold plated components and they're having voiding issues of this type with the eutectic gold tin solder, we can make recommendations on which solder would be most appropriate. We can supply it in either preform or gold tin solder paste, or even in wire form as needed by the customer.
And I understand you have information on this on your blog at Indium.com.
Sure. I've blogged about this and would also be very happy for anybody who's got further questions to email me, amackey@indium.com, as always.
Andy, thank you very much.
Sure, thank you.